All right, welcome to this brand new section. Here we are in the bonus section, and in this bonus section, I'm going to be showing you how to draw or color textures with colored pencils. So preferably, when I mean texture, I mean hair. So in this lecture, I'm going to be showing you how to draw hair with colored pencils. So for this lecture, I have a few colors here. So if you want, you can try to find colors that are similar to these ones. I just have a mid-tone brown, a dark brown, we have a yellow, an orange, and black and white. They don't have to be exactly like mine. These are just some tones we're going to be using to create our hair. So if you need to, go ahead and pause the video and find some colors. Alright, perfect. So we have our colors here. So what we're going to do first, let's just go ahead and take our black colored pencil. And we're just going to draw a small rectangle. Just like that. And we're going to be doing some straight hair in there. And now let's draw a large circle down here. And then let's draw a smaller circle in the middle. So it's about an inch across, and it doesn't have to be perfect. Mine's not perfect at all, but that's fine. And then let's just break it up into sections like this. All right, perfect. So now let's go back over to our rectangle, and we're gonna start out with this. So to start our hair, what we're gonna do is, let's go ahead, I'm just gonna turn my paper here for a second so I can get a better angle. Let's go ahead and start lightly shading in some, oops, I'm using the wrong brown. So let's take our darkest brown. Let's take our darkest brown color and lightly start shading in here along the edge. Now we don't want a perfectly straight edge. We want some darker brown to come out like that a little bit. You could do it in the middle as well. Just like that. And then let's lightly do a lighter layer along the edge until it fades out into nothing. Alright, now let's go ahead and do that on the same side. I mean on the other side. We'll do the same thing on the other side. Alright, and you can also do little things how I did, how some brown like jets out into the open like that. That's just going to be a little kind of shadow of the hair. It'll just make it, give it a lot better form and make it look more realistic. So now let's take a little bit lighter brown. This is the first brown I had where I accidentally started coloring there. So this is a little bit lighter brown. Now let's do the same thing but in the middle and just kind of blend that in. Now we don't want to be going too dark at first. First we want to, you know, kind of base in where we want our colors to be. All right, now let's go back to our original brown color. And now we're going to start coloring very dark. So this is where we don't want any paper to be showing through anymore. So we're just going to go over the same exact areas where we went before with this brown and color it in as dark as we can. If you need to, you can go back over and just trace out where your brown was like that and then just color inside. All right, let's go to the other side. Alright, now let's go back to our secondary brown, and we'll do the same thing in the middle. Now, it's okay if you go over the darker brown, since this is the darker color. How we've learned before, you can go over into the darker color with the lighter color when blending. It doesn't work so well the other way around, blending a darker color into a lighter color. So, let's go ahead and do this real quick. Alright, now once we've done that, what we're going to do now is take our white, and we're just going to go here in the middle and lightly just do some strokes in here, just very lightly. Just add a little shade of white. And it's okay if you get over into the darker brown, that's fine. You can do little fast streaks there. Alright, now we're going to be adding the things that gives it a hair texture or makes it look like hair. And what that is we're going to be using a technique with kind of a flick of the wrist. You're going to want to be pushing down hard at first and relieving pressure with a flick of the wrist, like this. Just like that. So go ahead and practice that a few times on your paper if you need to pause the video to do it a whole bunch. That's totally fine. You can go ahead and do that. So just a flick of a wrist, starting with firm pressure and releasing with the pressure with the flick of the wrist. All right. So now what we're going to want to do is take our yellow colored pencil and kind of go over our white areas just to give the hair more like color and make it look richer and more colorful. Give it a nice golden look. All right, there we go. Now let's go ahead and take our white one last time, and we're gonna put our final highlights in places where the hair is really gonna shine. So right up on top of here, I'm gonna add a little bit because it already looks pretty strong up there with a highlight. Put some down here, a little bit over here. Now, it doesn't have to be exactly like mine, just put it where you think it could use some. All right, there we go. Now coming all the way back to our black colored pencil, or sorry, our dark brown colored pencil. I'm gonna go ahead and sharpen mine real quick because for these last few pencil strokes, you're gonna want a very sharp pencil so they look like fine pieces of hair. So we have a sharp pencil. Now let's go ahead and bring this in, these strokes, and bring them all the way across. We can start here and just give it some strokes, flicking your wrist. Do the other side, and we want these to be jetting out into our lighter brown color. All right. Now finally we're going to do that again, but this time we're going to use our black colored pencil. But this time we want to stay mostly in the dark brown. We don't want to come too much out onto this, or we can, we just don't want to press too dark because the black is going to be very protruding. That's why we're going to mostly keep the darker pencil strokes in this dark brown. But we can come a little bit out into here and play around. All right, and there you go. You have a nice little patch of hair right there. If you want, also, you can go back through and take your brown and clean some things up. It looks like I have a big patch of yellow right there and right there. So I'll just clean that up real quick. And that is it. There's our first patch of hair. So nicely done. Now what we're going to do is we're going to move over to our circle. We're going to do a piece of hair, but it's going to be curved, which isn't too different. It's the same exact idea and concept as this. We're just going to be curving it this time. Okay, so once again, we're going to do the same thing. We are going to first add in our, I don't know, I don't want to call them shadows, our color blocking, just like this. So I'll give you a better view of this now. All right. Now let's take our second brown. Right, so we've done the same thing we did on the last one. We added our very light layers of our browns. Now let's go through and color them in really dark, just like we did last time. I'm just kind of blocking mine in so I know where to color, because I don't want to get out of bounds and color super dark in the lighter brown. Now moving on to our secondary brown. Gonna sharpen mine real quick a little bit. Alright, so we have our base colors drawn in. Now, doing a circle or curved hairpiece isn't going to be too difficult. The trickiest part about it is just going to be having to curve all of our hairlines, how we did on this one, going straight across. We're going to want to be flicking our wrist, but going in a curved motion. I kind of went in a curved motion on some of these, but we want to really be getting that curve in. So if you need to, go ahead and pause the video and try flicking your wrist, getting that curve in, starting with firm pressure and then less pressure as you flick your wrist. Okay. So now, once again, let's get our white colored pencil and let's start adding those values or highlights and start, make sure we're curving them. Okay. There we go. Now, let's get our yellow. And we're going to go over our white with that. To give it that nice gold look, because we want strong, healthy, beautiful hair. There we go. Then let's go back over with our white just to get some nice highlights in there. So we don't want it all to be yellow. And then once again, let's take our brown colored pencil that we started with. And you want to make sure it's sharp for this part, because this is where we're going to be adding those fine hairs. So let's go ahead and just start adding those across in the light section. You don't need too many. You don't need to go too crazy with it. Now with the black, now this, you do want to be careful. You don't want to go too crazy with the black. So we stay here mostly in this dark brown, but we can come out a little bit. Just be careful so you don't have a big ugly black hair just sitting there in the middle. Alright, and now let's take our white one more time and just go through there, adding some highlights. And we can do the same over here as well. Just go through with some white. Just like that. Alright, perfect. Congratulations, you have created two segments of beautifully textured hair. Now, to complete this lecture or assignment, what I want you to do is go ahead around the rest of this circle and finish it up. So you did one, I just want you to move to this one, and then this one, and finish the whole thing. And if you still need to, go ahead and practice flicking your wrist, getting that hair texture. And I can't wait to see what you guys did with this, and I can't wait to see all of your hair textures in the Q&A section. And I will see you in the next lecture.